It's a beautiful day. The sun is shining. I feel good. No one's gonna stop me now. Oh yeah. It's a beautiful day.
Good morning, boys and girls. Good morning. It is once again time for our reading. Are you ready? Are you ready? Wow, it has been beautiful days outside, hasn't it? But it's sure getting hot. I hope you got a pool in your backyard. If not, maybe mama let you go swimming in the bathtub. Whatever you do, make sure you stay cool, drink lots and lots of water, and of course, keep those hands washed. Keep those hands washed. You know that, okay? Excellent. Well, I'm glad to be back. I hope you're happy to be here. I hope you remembered your paper and your pencil again this time. If not, you know what to do. Pause, go get it. We'll be here when you get back, okay? Got some tough ones again for you today. I've been getting harder and harder every time. Once again, we're going to have these words that are not real words. They're make-believe words, but I know you guys have been rocking this. You've got this. So are you ready? Let's get started right away. Here we go. First word I want you to show me, crest. Now, that is a real word. You can crest the top of a mountain. That means when you get to the top, you've hit the crest. Some birds have pretty crests on their head. Those are the feathers that come out of the top of the back of their head. Yeah. So let's try that one. Crest. Show me that word. Crest. Did you get it? All right. Remember, I keep reminding this every single time, but I'm going to say it every time because I see that some of you are still doing it. You're waiting for me to make the word and then you're just copying it. No. That is not how you learn. And you know that. You can do this. I know you can. I believe in you. I don't want you to forget that either. Okay? You got this. Listen, think, and write. If I go too fast, just pause and write your word and then hit play again. Okay? All right, here we go. And again, say your sounds as you go. My first sound is k, k. I don't see big k, so it must be this little one. K. You got it, didn't you? Uh-huh. I see that. Here we go. Say the sounds. Point to your letters and say the sounds with me. Ready? K, S-t. Crest. Very nice. All right. Here we go. Let's try one of these silly words that's not a real word. Can you change crest to crast? Crast. Mm-hmm. You got it. I want to hear you. Make sure I can hear you. Say it nice and loud so I can hear you. That's it. You figured it out, didn't you? See, I told you these weren't hard. All right, let me see. Crest. You see which one I need to change, huh? Yeah, because you already did it. I need to get rid of my eh, and I need to change it for ah. Crest. Yep, I got it. Did you get it? Say your sounds. Point to them. Ready? Crest. Crest. Very nice. Moving quick. Let's change crest to trust. I know, it's another silly word. Try it. You got it. Listen to the sounds. Say it as you write it. Trust. You got this. Trust. Did you get it? I know you did. I'm looking. Don't wait for me. You write it. You write it. Hit pause if you have to. You write it. Here we go. Yep. Okay. Looks like you got it. Ready? I need trust. I don't hear a k anymore. Do you? Let's get rid of my k. What do I need to put instead? Yes, I need to put a t in there. Oop, oop, oop. There it goes. Point your letters. Say the sounds with me. T, ast, trust. Very, very nice. All right, ready? Let's change it to prast. Prast. You got it. Come on. Prast. Don't ask me what it means. It doesn't mean anything. I told you we're doing silly words. Prast. Mm-hmm. There you go. There it is. There it is. You ready? Say the sounds. Rast. I need to get rid of this one, don't I? And let's put, what do we need in there? P. Say the sounds with me. P. Ast. Prast. Wow. Amazing. All right. We're going to try something different. Are you ready? I'm going to use these same letters that I have right here, but I'm going to have to switch some of them around because I want to go from prast, listen carefully, trasp, trasp, don't need any of the new ones on top. I'm going to use the same letters I have down here, but I'm going to switch two of them around. So you're changing two sounds. Which two do I need to change? Trasp. You got it. Trasp. Show it to me. Come on, you got it. Ah, I'm fooling a couple of you. Say the sounds as you write it. Say the sounds. T-rasp. That looks better. Yes. What sounds do I need to switch? Check it out. T-rasp. I need to put this one over here, and I need to move this one over here, don't I? You got it. Point to the letters. Let's say the sounds. Make sure you've got it. T, r, a, s, p. Yes. Very good. Nice. Let me get rid of that. All right. Trasp. Wow. Excellent. Can you change trasp to trisp? Trisp. That's another tricky one, huh? Trisp. There it is. Say those sounds. It's easy when you say the sounds, isn't it? It is. It's easy when you say those sounds. Look at it. Trisp. Trisp. Did you hear it? Yeah, right there, huh? Let's change that one. T-r-isp. I got it. Did you get it? Say your sounds. Point to them. T-r-isp. Trisp. Fabulous. One more word. You ready? Last one. I promise. Last one. Ready? And I'm going to make this a real word. Real word. Let's go from trisp to crisp. Ooh, I like my pizza when it's crisp. That means it's got that crust on the bottom that crunches when you bite on it because it's crisp. Crisp. Yep, that's the one. That's the one. I see it. You got it. You got it. Yes. I love how I'm hearing you say your sounds. All of you that I hear saying your sounds, you're the one that's getting it right. Very cool. Makes it easier, doesn't it? Make sure you tell your friends that. All right, are we ready? Crisp. I need to get rid of this one, don't I? Yep. And what do I need to put instead? Yes. Very cool. Point to the letters. Say the sounds with me. Here we go. One more, last word. Let me hear you. I want to hear you nice and loud. I want to hear you. Crisp. crisp. Yes. Fantastic. Wow. Nice, nice work. All right. Once again, if you did all these by yourself, you didn't wait for me, you didn't copy, you listened, you thought, and you wrote all by yourself, saying the sounds as you did it, give me a thumbs up. Give me that thumbs up. Yes, yes. I'm loving seeing these on my movies. My movies are filled with thumbs ups. I love it. That means you're getting it. You got it. Wow. All right. Pencil down. What comes next? Yeah, you know this. Reading. All right, you ready to read? Ready to read? We got some hard ones again today. I told you, I keep challenging you guys. We only have 3 weeks left before you're in second grade. 3 weeks to be in second grade. You'll be ready, though. Trust me. All right, pencils are down. Yes, you too. Put it down. Put it down. Down, 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 down. Thank you. Leave it on the table. We read first. Here we go. First word. Ready for it? Here it comes. Here it comes. Oh, what does that say? I'm kind of in the way here, aren't I? I'm going to move myself over here just for right now. What does that say? Uh-huh. Very cool. And, well, come on. Get a hold of it here. All right, here we go. What does that say? Yes. Put them together. Mm-hmm. Hang on to it. La, la. Is that a word? No. Because you know what? There's more letters to come. But what does it say when we put those three together? What does it say? Lun. Hang on to your n. Ready? Lun. What's that word? Lunch. Are you getting hungry yet? Ooh, I know I'm getting hungry. I think it's almost time for lunch. Lunch. Got that word? Lun. Don't forget the n when you're writing it. Got it? Lunch. I'm going to cover it up. Now you can get your pencil and pick it up. Pick up your pencil. There you go. Say your sounds. Fabulous. Remember what letters make the ch, ch at the end? You got it? Got it? Very cool. All right, ready to check it? Let's check it. Lunch. Lunch. Is that what you have on your paper? I know you do. All right, very cool. That wasn't so hard now, was it? Yeah, that's easy. All right, you ready for the next one? Here we go. What's that say? Remember that's when you put your teeth on your lip? Put them together. Fur. Fur. I know, those ones with the er are kind of funny, huh? Fur. Ah. Put them all together. Frog. Ooh, maybe we're going to spell frog. Let's see. Ready? Frog. Doesn't say frog. What does that say? Fron. Fron. Is that a word? Wait, we're not done yet. Ready? Fron. What's that word? Front. What's a front? Something doesn't sound right, does it? Let's see. I know all of these sounds make only one sound, but this one, remember, sometimes it makes a different sound. We did this last time. Sometimes it makes a funny sound. Instead of front, what do you think it might be? Yeah, very good. Front. Remember how sometimes our ah says front. This is my front. This is my back. This is the front. Front. We spell it front, though, don't we? So I want you to say that. Say front. Because when you write it, that's what you need to say. Say it and write it. Very good. Sorry. It's doing it to me again. Here we go. Turn it off. Boom. Sorry. All right. What is it? Front. Got it? All right. Let's check it. Let's check it. What does it say? Front.
font. That's how we read it, the way it's spelled. But what does it really say? Front. You got it. All right, front. But we say front. You got it. All right, I'm going to move me back over. You know, I'm just going to move me down here. There we go. That'll work. All right, you ready for this one? Here we go. Tough one. Yep. What does that say? Not duh. We always do that. Don't do that. Not duh. Buh. 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 Got it? Buh. Oh, I know. I kind of showed you that one. All right, let's put all three of them together. You're getting so good at this. Put all three of them together. Bleh. Bleh. There we go. Blin. Blin. That's not a word, is it? We're not done yet. Here we go. Blin. Blink, blink. You know, like when you do this with your eyes and you blink, 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 blink. See my eyes? Blink. Everybody blink. There you go. Blink, blink. But if you're not careful, you're going to write blick. Don't write blick. Make sure you write blink. Ready? I'm going to cover it up. Do it. You got it. That's it. Yes, say those sounds. I can hear you. Very good. Very good. Nice. Ready to check it? Let's check it. Say those sounds with me. Ready? Blink. You didn't forget the did you? Blink. Blink. If you blink your eyes too fast, you'll get dizzy. Yeah, don't do that. All right. Two more words. Two more. Ready? Here we go. Put your pencil down. Yeah, I see you trying to sneak it. Why are you copying? You know you can't learn that way. You got to listen, think, look at it, think. You got this. Put it down. Thank you. Don't think I can't see you. I can see you over there. All right, ready? Here's the next one. Move, 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 move. Ah, there it is. Ready? St. Yeah, we've seen that before, huh? Put them together. St, st, st. All right, now get ready. Two sound, two letters, one sound. Here we go. I want to see if you remember the sound. Here it is. What does that say? Yeah. Ooh, So it's stew. Duh. Stewed. Let's try the other sound. Remember, this makes two sounds. Ooh, Let's try that one. Stood. Stood. I stood up in my seat. And Miss Glick said, don't stand on your chair. So I stood back down. Stood. Stood. Remember, when they make more than one sound, you got to try them both and see which one fits, just like we did over here. When ah didn't work, remember? We flipped the sound, try another one. All right, stood. Uh-oh, I lost it, there it is. Okay, write it. Say the sounds. Say the sounds as you go. Did you get it? I know you did. Ready, you wanna check it? Ready to check it? Let's check it. What does that say? Stood. Stood. See how much better you're getting at this? You're getting so good. All right, here comes the big one. The big one. Remember, two little words, we put them together, makes one big word. So we read it in our chunks. We're going to read first one chunk, then we'll read the other chunk. Okay? Got it? Here we go. Here is my first chunk. What does that say? Seh. Seh. You know that's not a word, huh? Seh. Seh. That's pretty easy. All right, let's check the other chunk. What does that say? That one's a little bit harder. Cret. 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 I think think we might have to do some flipping here. Let's put them all together. Sacret. Doesn't sound right, does it? What other sound does this say? Sometimes it says eh, and sometimes it says e. Let's try e. Secret. Hey, I know that word. What's that word? Secret. Do you have a secret? I have a secret. You are getting smarter. But it's not a secret because everybody knows it. What's that word? Secret. Secret. I have a secret. I'm going to cover it up. That's my secret. Now say the sounds as you write it. Careful. There you go. You got this. You got this. Even these big words are getting easy for you. All right, you ready to check it? Let's check it. Here we go. So point to it and say the sound. I want to make sure you got them all. Ready? S-E-C-R-E-T. Secret. Secret. Yes. Remember, sometimes E says E when it's all by itself. Secret. You got it. Wow. All right. I'm going to grab my pen. Grab my pen. There it is. Boom. Got it. Let's read this first word. Tell me what it says. Tell me again. Lunch. Nice. Now, what do I have to underline? Because I think there's something here I need to underline. What is it? Yes, the ch. Two letters, one sound. Lunch. What's this one? Read it for me. Yeah, it looks like front, huh? But is that what we say? No, what do we say? Remember, I'm going to write it up here so we remember. You can put it on yours too so you remember. It's got that funny sound. What does it say? Front. Nice. But just remember, though, when you write it, we need to put that ah. Okay? Front. There you go. I know it's a tricky one. That's one of those you got to get stuck in your head. You got this. All right, read this one for me. Very good. That one was easy, huh? What does it say? Blink. Blink. Do we need to underline anything? Nope. They all make their own sound. B-l-ink. Very good. All right, read this one. Careful. Read this one. What does it say? Stood. Yes. Now, I need to underline this, right? Because there's two letters, one sound. But listen, remember, does it make its first sound or its second sound? Because two O's says ooh, ooh. Which one is it using here? Ooh, stood, or stood? Number two, huh? So let's write our two over the top. Write your two over the top. That'll help us remember. There we go. Stood. Nice. Very, very nice. All right. Let's do this last one. You got it. Come on. Read the chunks. What's that first chunk? C. And the next chunk? Cret. What is it when we put them together? Secret. Nice. Do I need to underline anything? No. But does one of them make their second sound? Did we have to flip it? Yeah. Remember, this one doesn't say eh. It says E. It's its second sound, so put a two over the top. Wow. Fantastic. See, look at this. I keep giving you harder words, and you keep rocking it. I love this. You got all of those. You read them. Say, Miss Glick, I am a rock star. I didn't hear you. What was that? Yes, you are rock stars. I love it. Put your pencil down. Put your pencil down. Whew. Very, very good. Nice. See, we're getting better at our reading. All that's working for you. Nice. So now let's have a look at our story. If you remember last time, we were talking about, what was this? Problem and solution. Remember what a problem and a solution is? Remember I told you it's kind of like this jigsaw puzzle. You get a puzzle and it's all in a bunch of little pieces and we don't know what it's going to be. That's a problem. It's a puzzle and we've got to figure it out. When we find our solution, we put all those pieces together. That's how we solve the puzzle, right? When we solve the puzzle, we have our solution. And in our stories, There's usually a problem. There's a puzzle, something that's wrong. And we have to find the solution. We have to find a way to fix it. We fix these pieces by putting them together to make a picture. When we have a problem in our story, we have to put it together. We have to find the solution, find a way to solve the problem. Okay, remember last time we read that story about Marco and his birthday? They wanted to have his tradition, which is always having a family dinner for birthday. And he wanted to try something new. So what did they do? They found a solution. They still had their family dinner, but they did it in a park so he could have his friends come. And that made a new tradition. You remember that story? Cool. Well, I have a new story today. And I'm going to ask you to help me. We are going to read this story about Lissy. This is Lissy and Lissy's friends. She's going to make some friends. And it's kind of neat because in this story, she kind of shares with us a tradition she has in her family too. Okay, so let's watch and see. Lissy's Friends by Grace Lynn. First, we're going to find out what her problem is. Help me see if we can find her problem. Lissy was the new girl at school. Get rid of that. Lissy was the new girl at school. Nobody talked to her. Nobody smiled at her. At the playground, Lissy stood on the merry-go-round by herself. You starting to see what her problem is? Yeah, you're right. Have you ever been the new girl at school or maybe the new boy at school? Have you ever felt like Lissy? How do you think she feels right now? She's probably kind of sad. She's new at school. She's the new one there. Because Lissy ate lunch alone, she was finished before lunchtime was over. Since she didn't have anything else to do, Lissy took the lunch menu in front of her and began to fold it. Soon, she had made a little paper crane. A crane is a little bird. She's got her lunch menu, and she's going to fold it up to make a little crane. Pretty cool, huh? Do you know how to make a paper crane? It's something that they learn where she comes from. She comes from China, and in China, they like to make animals by folding up papers. It's a tradition that she learned in her country. Hello, Lissy said to the paper crane. I will call you Menu. Because she made from the menu, get it? That's pretty good. And you will be my friend. And to her surprise, Menu opened its eyes and blinked at her. Menu looked to the right, then to the left, and fluttered up its paper wings. Whoa! It came alive. Look at that. That's pretty cool. The rest of the day, Lissy smiled a secret smile, because she knew she had a secret friend that nobody else did. That's pretty cool. Did you make any friends in school today? Mommy asked Lissy when she came home. Well, Lissy said, patting Menu in her pocket, I did make one friend. Good, Mommy said. I'm sure you will make more tomorrow. Ooh, Mommy thinks she made real friends. And she did. The next day, Lissy made lots of friends. But is she making friends with the other boys and girls? No, what's she making? Look at that. She made a cat. Ooh, or maybe that's an owl. And a rabbit, and I'm not sure. She's making all kinds of friends to go with Menu here. She's making her own friends. That's pretty cool. Her friends went with her everywhere. She took them with her to the bus stop. Look, she's even got a big giraffe. She rode it with them on the bus. She took them with her to school and to the library. I bet she read lots of really cool stories to them. Those are the best kind of friends, the ones that you can read to. And Lissy was never alone. Wow. All right, so now let's stop and think here for a minute. Lissy had a problem at the beginning of the story that made her feel really sad. Do you remember what it was? Right. Remember, she was the new girl at school. Lissy was the new girl at school. And what happens when you're new? A lot of times, you don't have many friends, do you? Lissy was the new girl at school, and she had no friends. That made her feel sad and lonely, huh? I know, I've felt like that before too. Nobody wants to be lonely. Luckily at our school, we don't make new friends sit by themselves, huh? We always find them. All right, so she was at the new girl's school and she had no friends. What did she do? She make friends? Yeah, she actually made her friends, huh? She didn't go out and say hi to somebody to try and make a new friend by being friendly to somebody else. Instead, she actually made them herself by folding the papers together. So she actually made some new friends. She made some new friends, whoops, out of paper. Wow. I'm going to write this over here because maybe we can look up and look into this a little bit later and find out more about it. Remember I told you this is something that she learned in her country. It's a tradition that she has there. It's a special way of doing art. It's called origami. Ask your mom. Maybe she can help you look it up on the internet. After we're done here, you can come back and pause the video right here so you can see that word and look it up on the internet and see what it tells you what origami is. I'm going to tell you, origami is a kind of art where you fold paper to make different things, usually animals. It's really kind of cool. So Lissy was a new girl at school and she had no friends. That was her problem. How did she solve it? She made new friends out of paper. That was pretty smart of her, wasn't it? She's not alone anymore, is she? She actually looks pretty happy, doesn't she? Look, she's got all of her friends around her. That is so cool. I wonder if they all talk to her like Menu does. That would be pretty neat, wouldn't it? Do you think that part of the story is real, or is it you think it's in her imagination? Yeah, I think it's her imagination too. And you know what? I've got a secret for you. This story is not over. Next time, we're going to read the rest of the story and see what happens with Lizzie and all her new friends, okay? But for right now, we're going to stop there because she's already solved one problem. But I got a hint for you. She's got another problem coming up here pretty soon, and we're going to help her solve that one. So right now, we are going to stop right here. I'm going to leave you wondering what happens with Lizzie and her friends. We're going to find out next time. Your job right now is to read another story. I got another Raz Kids for You story. Here it is. And you're going to come over here and do the same thing we did. You're going to find the problem. You're going to see what the solution was. And I like this part at the end. I heard some great answers on that last one. Remember that last story? How many of you read that last story? The last piece of cake, remember? Yeah, that was a funny story. I love that one. And I loved your answers. You came up with your own solutions to the problem. I love that. It's because you're so smart and you're thinking good. Well, I got another story here for you. This one's called Two for Me, One for You. And again, it's over here, Raz Kids. Big green button. Boom. Find your name. Boom. Put in your initials. Boom. And then go to your reading. Go to the assignment spaceship right over here. And in here, you're going to look for that story that we just saw in our paper. Remember, if you forget what it is, you can look over here. Two for me, one for you. And that's what it looks like. That's why I put that picture on there. Look, there it is right there. I'm going to open up this story. And you are going to read this story all by yourself. You can kind of already see, looks like two brothers here. I wonder what their problem is. Maybe it's got something to do with these toys. Your job. Read this story. Read it. Remember when you're reading too, if you click this little red microphone up here, I would love to hear you reading your stories for me. Okay? I really want to hear you. I miss your voices. Click that little button and while you read it, it'll record your voice just like I'm recording mine right now. It doesn't record your face, but it will record your voice so I can hear you. Record your story for me. Let me hear you. And then you're going to come over here and tell me, what is the problem in this story? How did they solve that problem? And if you were there, what would you do to solve this problem? Okay? This is our job. You got this. Okay? You got this. I know you do. All right. Boys and girls, we're getting close to the end of first grade.
I want you to keep stretching your brain, keep thinking, keep working. I love it. I miss you guys so bad. I really, really do. Please record your voice so I can hear you. I hope I see you on our chat this week, Thursday afternoons, 5:30. Be there. It's a lot of fun. You get to say hi to all your friends, okay? All right. Well, stay safe. Stay healthy. Again, don't forget to thank Mom and Dad for their help. Give them a big hug for me and for you. And tell Mom to give you a hug for me, because I miss being able to give you guys hugs. I miss my hugs in the morning, okay? All right. Boys and girls, I will see you again very soon. Take care. Bye.